you should be quite proud of what you have accomplished. Before D3 and the work of its community, to replicate a map like this in the browser would be quite an arduous process and require many tools. And we are now done with the first step of creating our map of the World Cup games. The next step is to add some context to our map and add in the attendance data of each of the World Cups throughout the years, plotted on our map. To do so, we're going to be plotting circles on each country in which the World Cup was held with the radius proportional to the total attendance for that year. This is often referred to as thematic mapping, which refers to the fact that maps with such data often represent a specific topic or, you guessed it, theme. In our case, the theme will be the World Cup, and thematic maps are often implemented by adding some additional context, by leveraging some data plotted on the map. There's a few common types of thematic maps, many of which we have covered previously in the lessons. What we have seen previously are dot maps, which simply plot dots, potentially of different colors, on a map and can leverage negative space. Choropleth maps, which color areas such as counties, states, or countries, depending on the data they represent. And a cartogram, which distorts area, shapes, and sizes, depending on some data value. And what we'll be covering in this class is a graduated symbol map. It is a symbol map because we place some symbol, in our case circles, on the map, and it is graduated because the area, or radius in our case, of the symbols varies depending on the data they represent.